Meanwhile, a school orchestra from Dorset is leaving for the Soviet Union this weekend. The young musicians are...
We have been abroad before, to France, Germany, Spain and Switzerland last October, but this is by far the most ambitious and prestigious trip that we've undertaken.
What do you think the Russian people are going to make of your music?
Oh, the great music lovers over there, I know from personal experience, and I'm sure we'll get very warmly received.
I hope it's going to be very nice to mix with the people and stuff, so I'm really looking forward to it.
I think they'd probably be surprised, because we're known as school orchestra. They don't think it's going to be very good, and we are a good orchestra.
It's changing everywhere at the moment in Russia, so I don't know what to expect at all.
What do you think they'll make of your music?
I think they like it.
It's a communist country, it's just... different.
And how do you think they're going to react to your playing?
I think they love it.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Walkie-talkie, the back seat, Mark Redmond. Is Alice on this one, Alice?
Is doors and little things. Remote apartments on the ground floor. Well, the city, Leningrad, is rather new city in the terms of the world history. It was founded by Russian Tsar Peter the Great in the beginning of the 18th century during the war against Sweden. Originally, this part of the country belonged to Russia since the 13th century. It was very important for the country because almost all the trade routes which led to the south and the east of the country started from the Baltic Sea. In the 17th century, Sweden occupied this territory and Russia was completely cut off to any access to the sea, which impeded economic development of the country. So that's why Peter the Great launched the war against Sweden. It was a very long war, 21 years, but in the beginning of the war, in 1703, he got his first victory over Swedish army, and in memory of this victory, he founded a fortress. He called the fortress St. Petersburg. Germany, the German word St. Petersburg was translated into Russian, Petrograd, which means exactly the same, the city of Peter. And in 1920, counts and Russian merchants, also the former companies, theaters, movie houses, and of course now this part of this street is the main commercial, you know, center of Leningrad, the business center. There are many shops. This yellow building to the right hand side, you can see a yellow building with white columns, classical style. It belonged to a very rich family, Russian family. The name of the family is the Yusupovs. In the middle of the design is the architectural center of the city of St. Petersburg. 3-1-3, you will see the square very well when you go to the Hermitage. You will walk along the square. A green building on your left hand side with the, you know, statues on the roof is the Winter Palace, the main residence of Russian Tsars. It was built in the second half of the 18th century by architect Russ Kelly. In 1762 it was built. It was commissioned by the daughter of Peter the Great, Elizabeth, but she died before the palace was finished, so she never lived in the Winter Palace. It was used by the other Tsars, and it turned into exhibition halls. And you will see the Winter Palace the day after tomorrow, when you go to see the Hermitage. You will see the former state rooms and the living quarters. And of course you will see the rest of the Hermitage. The Hermitage is a very huge museum. It is housed in five buildings. One of them is the Winter Palace and four more. So you can see the panorama of the Hermitage from this side across the river, you know, the Winter Palace, and then you will see three more buildings, which is
thank you. haciendo reloj.
Okay, is there one there?
Okay. One blue, one red, one yellow. Okay?
No,
how much of this?
I got like 10 more. Okay, I'm freaking out.
Here's Stanford.
I was given it on the way out the door.
For 10 or 11 years, and then you decide, or your parents decide for you what you're going to do next. Or you go to work, or you go to study further. So in order to enter the Kovlak plaque on the entrance with the bas-relief of very famous Russian chemist named Diliev, he invented periodical system of elements. He used to study and then work a lot in this university of Leningrad, of St. Petersburg University. And now, as I told you, 20,000 students study here in 15 departments, not only Leningraders, but the people from other cities and from other countries. We have British, American, French students. They study Russian in the university for a semester, 4 months or 6 months. The second half of the 19th century in eclectical style. Now the buildings are used for different purposes. There is a bank here, the consulate for German Democratic Republic, and the others. If you look on your right hand side, you can see again the Academy of Sciences, the yellow building. The red building is the university. The green building is also the part of the university, and there students study languages, English, French, you know, Chinese, Japanese, and the others. Square ahead of you, very famous square. Unfortunately, we can't park here for very long time. Just for 5 minutes, the bus will park, and you can take pictures either from the windows if you open them, or just two or three of you will get out, you know, for 5 minutes only. So this square is named after the deceased. And one of them is the golden star. Can you see the star? Well, when we turn, you will see it again. So this is the highest decoration of this of the country. It means that Leningrad is the city hero. Hero city. It all the Tsars are buried. The Tsars before Peter the Great were buried in the Kremlin in Moscow. Probably you will see their great public meetings. And after the February and October revolutions, they buried in the middle of the square those people who were killed in the street clashes. So in the center of the square now you can see granite walls, these are flags, half masks, and you can see eternal flame. Just now you will see the eternal flame. So that's the place where revolutionaries, just behind that group of people, there is a flame.
Oh yes.
The revolution.
Вы уже так, знаете, быстрее переедете, правильно? То мы так не
хотим.
Лавровый снова сидим тоже 5 минут там, а потом, может быть, даже Смольный так проедем.
Просто проедем, да.
Посмотрим.
October Revolution 1917. The Cruz Aurora is a military ship, but at the same time it's a museum, so people can go aboard the ship, but not every day. Monday and Friday it's called. And there is the Hotel Leningrad too, that construct was built 18 years ago. Was built in the middle of the 18th century on the order of Count of Elizabeth, the daughter of Peter the Great, as a nunnery. Later, in the end of the 18th century, Catherine the Great founded a school here for the girls from the noble families. It was the most, you know, prestige school in.
Вы знаете, где вот где-то автобус везет, а жена туда ставит. Так и разворачиваются все дальние.
Я понимаю, но там...
А там, пока вы ставите автобус, все время подряд.
И деда сейчас станет сюда. bring our music right up to date with a modern piece called Troublemaker by the English composer Mike Davis.
А сейчас, чтобы сменить настроение, мы бы хотели исполнить очень современную вещь композитора Майка Дэвиса. Практически эта вещь была написана не так давно. Это современное произведение, которое называется «Хулиган», «Troublemaker». With your repertoire, which was interesting, very various, and we really like all of it.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Well, it sounds as if you are.
Thank you. Oh, I'm here together. This is KGB here. Over there? We are following a posse of very strange English people. There's very funny man with camera here, and very funny photographer.
Are we in Pakistan or Russia?
I don't blame you. It's a very tricky place. I don't know, sir. I'm very sorry. Thank you. I'll just get out of the way.
Soviet Union. You know, the Soviet Union is the country of more than 100 nationalities. And the Soviet Union was formed in 1922 when four republics, I don't know, separate states unite. There were four of them. Russia, Belarus, the Ukraine, and Transcaucasian Republic, which split later into three, Georgia, Armenia, and Azerbaijan. Later, more and more republics were joined, altogether now 15. But of course, now, you know, there are many arguments about if it was right for three Baltic republics to enter. They think that it was not the just, you know, act signed by Stalin, you know, and the leaders of that republic to enter the Soviet Union. But traditionally, historically, all these peoples who formed the Soviet Union or who later formed the Soviet Union, for example, the Finnish Republic, it was the part of Russian Empire since the 12th century. For example, Lithuania, Estonia were the part of the Russian Empire since the 12th century. Estonia was conquered by German knights, by Dutch kings, you know, a couple of times, and lately it was joined to Russia. So, but of course they have, according to the Soviet Constitution, they have the right to leave the Union any moment. And that's what going to do the Lithuania at the moment, and Estonia wants to do it also. Recently, a week ago, they had the Supreme Congress, which decided to do the same as Lithuania. But I don't know why, you know, probably because of the French traditions, or probably because the central leadership doesn't want to, and also because of the economic, you know, reasons, because the economy of all the parts of the Soviet Union were all mixed up, you know, how to say, tight, too closely, you know, it's not easy to do it.
Little village and there is 1,000 kilometers to another one. But a lot of major construction.
The boat over there. These things were used for agriculture. The ladies dressed in such a way. Two horses, smaller horses on both sides,
And the way I train, especially to go, you know, it's special way, you know, to have the alert, you know, three horses, you know, they have different steps, you know, to move properly. So the whole thing is usually called troika. So three horses and a sleigh or a carriage. Russian people used to travel by these troikas, and very often you can find in the poetry, like Pushkin wrote a lot of poems, and he mentioned troikas. I hear the sound of the bells of the troika, which leads me to travel again. I like to travel very much. And usually the second horse had this.
Well, it's a different one. The work was very hard, especially. Well, maybe not because
You could look up the date.
Yeah.
When we get back.
I have to do some revisions.
That one died in 1924.
A sunny day in Moscow. Beautiful place of the world.
What?
What are you doing then?
If you move over here, we'll show you the more higher class here.
Hey? Yep, it's a shithole.
This is my friend.
No,
get out of here.
Go away. Go away. Morning. Morning.
Hey.
One of that little lights on at the front. You know, I'm rolling. You like to say a word for the camera, Ron?
Is that what it is? Is that the red light, is it?
That's what it is, Ron. I like to say a word for the camera.
Well,
I don't want you to have the usual feelings when you see a red light, Ron, all right?
Well, I've got to say, I'm impressed with Moscow. There's a lot of red lights up there. Sorry?
What, that one? No, that one, yeah, it's picking it out on picking it up. Get Emma, so it's got off the
just had a 7-hour delay getting to rooms because there was no rooms for us available for us in Moscow. So apart from that, it's wonderful. But if you'd just like to tell her that, is she in tomorrow, do you know? Roughly what time is it there tomorrow, at the moment? At the moment? Right. Well, would you just tell her that I'll try and ring her tomorrow I'll try and book a call so that it gets through to you at about 11 o'clock. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I'd just like to have a chat to her, that's all, about one or two things here, because, you know, we're with Homefield School Orchestra. Right, well, there's just one or two interesting things I'd like to talk to her about.
The whole thing had been a total cock-up, didn't you? that's not what you said, wasn't it?
Not those words, cock-up. I'm too polite for that.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Well, I think the printing process might already be underway back in Bournemouth, so...
Really?
Sorry about that.
You've been quoted Mr. David Smith of Simpton. Oh. Lately of Simpton.
Just report me to the press council, OK?
No hey, Roddy, it's in the black camera bag. All right, mate.
OK.
Think of the tax relief.
They've got Nouvelle as well.
Where's
Richard? Yeah, we're Questa over here doing Nouvelle. I'll come and talk to you, mate.
Questa over here doing
in his element.
It's new problem. It goes back to the 16th, 17th century, and the ancient tombs are only in the cathedral, and there are some outside.
Yeah, I've just got you in there nicely now, John.
赤の広場っていうこと手前に。
Saving that even. Where in the notice, lads?
James, at least pretend. At least pretend.
Can we have you all over here, please?
Are you all pretend?
Jason, out.
Ready?
Geordie, Paul, out of the way. You know what, scummy little devils in the photograph. Off it.
All right, guys, whenever you're ready.
Split the money, lads.
I think we've been here.
Do that again and then change the place. Do it again
place. We've got to get out of the way.
Yeah, you got enough, John.
Yeah, I forgot the
part.
I got
this. What's this part? Это же дела такие.
Хорошо еще. Хорошо еще так быстро
работает. Я понимаю,
I take he doesn't mind, really. He's just doing his job, is he? No. Yeah. Thank you.
你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那儿。不是，那你那儿闪着了那
Thank you. Keep up, please. He's got a ticket system on the go. Ray, can we? She's doing tickets at the door.
Beautiful.
You like that, mate?
Right, lads, just got to get the
instruments out. Did you get the sound on it?
Yeah.
Did you get the sound on it? Right, take some pictures.
There's Zara's canopy pew over there.
Right.
And
they said no video.
No, not at all.
But I am filming.
I don't think that
she's much allowed to
take pictures.
No, she said no video.
Yeah. What's
the light? Let's go and have a look at the
main people, that's for icon.
Yeah.
Behind me.
What's the noise?
Thank you. straight into the next movement. Last five bars. Three big warm sound, remember.
Thank you.
I just want the lovely Mrs. Partridge in there. That's all.
She's going to hide now.
Thank you.
Sebastian Bach was still alive today, he would as well. I hope that if Johann Sebastian Bach was alive today, he wouldn't have enjoyed this castle. Thank you.
I'd just like to say on behalf of the whole group, the whole party, But I would like to get my own back. mother in